Hi, today I want to show you how to overcome the restrictions having only a limited budget for your game and therefore only being able to use a limited amount of assets. So I'll show you one way how to modify assets. I also want to show what I did in-game since the last video. It hasn't been too much though. If you have close to zero budget for your game development, you will have to look around for low-cost or free-of-charge assets and tools. This is the case for me, so I'm limited to the amount of available options for assets to include. For example, I've already chosen this clipboard. It is free and matches the style I'm using for Aaron Hellbringer. The only problem is, there's exactly one copy of it, and if I was to use it over and over like this, it would really look strange, wouldn't it? So if you are limited in the assets, you have to modify it in a way users will not easily recognize that this is the same copy or the same basis. Let's dive in. First, one has to figure out how the asset actually works. Usually, you have a starting point by examining the prefab or one of the prefabs if it's a larger asset. In this case, we have only the original and one duplicated prefab by me for this video. So I click Open Prefab and we see this one is pretty simple. We have one root object that just has one transform and an animator attached to it. But I want to alter the appearance of the clipboard, not add an animation. Perhaps later. I have nothing to do here. We also have two child objects, board and page. The board contains a mesh renderer and two shaders, one for the board itself and one for the metal clip attached to it. It would not make sense changing the shaders to alter the appearance. It would work, but it also would apply to any duplicated version of the prefab. If I alter the albedo of the board, it changes. But as you can see in the scene here, rather in the prefab, and there in the scene, every version has been changed. Of course, I could make several copies of shaders, but having a copy of a shader just for a different appearance of an object is really an overkill. I don't recommend it. One needs to make the changes at the correct position, or rather, at the correct component. Let's reset this to white first. And now, open the materials subdivision. Here we can see two familiar components in this materials array. One material for the board and one for the metal clip. We can duplicate and alter any of these materials and even use them later on completely different objects. If you click them, Unity is so nice to automatically show the location in the projects folder. Let's duplicate the board material. Now I rename one to Board Dark and edit its albedo to something close to black and assign the new material to the clipboard prefab named To Be Dark. And there we have it. Two prefabs which have a different look. I can do this also for the metal and also for the page. And the final result looks like this. The lights and shadows looked like this before. And at the house, you could see the light leaping out of the walls, for example. And on the inside, the rooms have not been filled out by the light like one would expect. I was not really satisfied, so I tried out several checkboxes, lightning and baking, so we finally have shadows here. And also the lanterns are more lantern-like. There are still some minor issues I haven't addressed yet, but I'm positive to be able to fix them. I also added some fog around the camp to add some darker mood. And in the house, ah wait. Outside you can see there is no light leaping through the walls anymore. I'm satisfied with that one. And also on the inside the rooms are really lighted up the way they should be. I used two different light sources for that. I also redesigned the living room, adding a small kitchen with extra light for more realism. But well, that's already it. I will fine-tune the smaller issues but mainly concentrate on a greater refactoring. This one has become necessary in order to add the skills Aaron should be able to use later. I will see you at the 3rd of November then. Until then, bye.